For Honor has changed in a number of different ways from its original release in February 2017, and mainly the game is running on dedicated servers, and the game has had a core combat update that makes fighting against other characters more fun and engaging. A lot of new and returning players have come back to the game in order to learn the mechanics of it or to refresh their memory. And like Rainbow Six Siege, even though the game is in year 4, it's still getting updates, patches, new heroes, and hero reworks. This For Honor guide aims to teach you about the combat of For Honor, its world, its modes, its customization, and everything in between. One of the best ways to learn about For Honor's combat mechanics and its modes is by watching guides like this one and by going to the training option in the menu. From there, you'll be able to go into the training area and hero tactics in order to fight against bots to hone your skills. You'll be able to play in the apprentice trials and the warrior trials in order to learn about the basic combat mechanics of For Honor. And you'll be able to go into the training media to learn about the game modes and customization of For Honor. Alright, so now I'm going to be showing you how to fight in For Honor. So your character has a light attack and a heavy attack. The light attack does less damage and is faster, and the heavy attack does more damage and is slower. And you can block attacks by matching your guard direction to the incoming attack's direction. If you block a light, your opponent's combo is going to end, generally. Some characters like Warlord have light attacks that don't get interrupted if you block them. If you end up blocking a heavy attack, however, it's not going to be interrupted, just like the light attack. And instead of blocking attacks, you can do what is called a parry. Simply switch your guard to the direction of the incoming attack, and when the indicator starts flashing, press your heavy button to perform a parry. And just one thing to note, ever since the core combat update, if you get parried by somebody else, you're not going to lose half your stamina anymore. Your parry punishes depend on what type of attack you parry. For example, on a light attack parry, you are guaranteed a heavy attack punish. If you get a heavy parry, you are guaranteed a light as a punish. Unblockable attacks need to be parried and cannot be blocked. Some unblockable attacks cannot be parried and therefore have to be dodged. Those attacks are called bashes. Speaking of dodging, some characters like the Warden have special dodge attacks that they could perform after successfully dodging an opponent's attacks to punish him. Some attacks are undodgeable, and you can easily recognize them by the blue effect that they produce. Some characters have special attacks that they could perform after they parry you. Those attacks are called parry counters. Some characters can perform crushing counters with certain attacks. Let's take the Warden's stoplight as a crushing counter example. When the opponent does his attack, you line your guard up with his top attack and you do your top light to perform his crushing counter. Some shield characters like the Conqueror have full block stances that can block attacks coming from any direction. And some characters also have counters when you hit their shield. Full block stances are very vulnerable to guard breaks. Now, guard breaks are very useful for opening up people who turtle with full block stance or people who like to dodge, and also people who like to throw raw heavy attacks at you. And when you get a guard break, you could usually get a side heavy punish. Now, if you successfully land a guard break, you could throw the opponent down the ledge or into a wall to get a greater punish than what you originally had. To counter another player's guard break, all you have to do is press your guard break button whenever the opponent guard breaks you. So the opponent guard breaks you and you press your guard break button to do a counter guard break. Some attacks like Warden's fully charged shoulder bash have super armor, meaning that if you try to hit the opponent during their super armor, your attack will hit them, but they will go right through your attack and punish you. Armored moves cannot be interrupted by regular attacks, but they can be interrupted by bashes. Now, certain heavy attacks, zone attacks, or bashes could be feinted. And you can feint your attacks into guard breaks or other attacks in either direction to confuse the opponent and mix them up. Now, some characters can do a different version of the feint called the soft feint. And a soft feint is when you transition from one attack to the other seamlessly without having to press the feint button. And you can do a soft feint into another side attack or a bash or a guard break, and a soft feint is always going to be faster than a regular feint. Now, if you attack too much or you feint too much or you get hit by bashes too much, your stamina bar below your health is going to get depleted and you will become out of stamina. While you are out of stamina, your attacks are going to be slower, you won't be able to feint, you won't be able to sprint, and if you get parried or thrown while you are out of stamina, you will be thrown to the ground and the opponent will be able to get the maximum punish on you. So be careful not to deplete your stamina bar. Now, certain characters can perform moves called deflects, and to do a deflect, you simply dodge into an attack. And if you do a deflect, you're going to be able to get certain punishes. In Orochi's case, it is a guaranteed light. Now, just like parrying, the more you practice deflects, the better you become at them. When you press your light and heavy button at the same time, you perform a character-specific zone attack. Zone attacks have a different range of properties based on the character you are playing. Now, I just finished telling you about the basic combat mechanics of For Honor, but if you would like to learn about a specific character, for example, you could check out YouTube for different character guides, and you can also check out some of my own guides that I'm gonna have on the info card on the top right of this video. And I will also include a link in the description that's going to take you to a page where you're simply going to have to scroll over to the hero of your choice and you'll be able to find the guide associated with him. Now, before we talk about the different game modes of For Honor, we're going to talk about the different classes of this game. So, For Honor has four classes: the Vanguard, the Heavy, the Assassin, and the Hybrid. And each of these classes can earn renown differently based on the actions that they take on the battlefield. So, how do you check what class is your character? You go onto the character select screen, and to the left side of the difficulty of the character, you're going to see the class. And if you go and click on your character and go to his moveset and scroll all the way down, you're going to see how you can earn your renown with the specific class. So, a Vanguard can earn renown by being in outnumbered fights, by controlling objectives, and by killing enemy soldiers. Assassin heroes can earn renown by fighting in 1v1 duels, by killing other enemy heroes, and by getting killstreaks. The Heavy class can unlock more renown by assisting, reviving, or saving other heroes, and by defending objectives. Hybrid classes are a little bit different. They don't earn more or less renown based on specific activities that they do, but rather their renown is balanced across activities, meaning that you can do any number of activities and you're going to get the same amount of renown. Now, renown enables you to get things called feats. So feats are like killstreaks in For Honor. They are abilities that dynamically change the flow of a fight. And there are four tiers of feats that you can unlock. The first tier, which is all the way up, is going to be the easiest feat to unlock, and it's typically going to be the weakest. When you go all the way down, you're going to have your tier 4 feat, which is the final feat that you unlock, and it's typically going to be the strongest. And as you earn feats, you're going to see that there are passive feats, and they are feats that require you to activate them. Passive feats are feats that are gray, so as soon as you unlock the feat, you get the ability. You don't have to activate anything. Now, yellow feats are feats that require an activation. So you have to press a certain input to activate the feat, and then the feat has to recharge in order to be used again. Now, as you level up your characters, you're going to have more and more feats to choose from. When you unlock all the feats, and typically you could do it after one day, you'll have a choice of 3 feats per tier to choose from. So now that you know about feats and renown, we're going to start talking about the various game modes of For Honor and explain each and every one of them. So the first game mode that we're going to be talking about is going to be Duel. Duel, as the name implies, is a 1v1 game mode where you have to defeat the opponent to win a round. Win 3 rounds before the opponent does and you win the match. Next mode we're going to talk about is going to be 2v2 Brawls. It's the same concept as 1v1s, but you are a team of 2 against another team of 2, and you have to once again win 3 rounds in order to win the match. One thing that's also worth noting is that if you're fighting in 2v2 or 4v4 game modes and you successfully survive a gank or an attack from multiple people at the same time, you will unlock a power-up of sorts called Revenge. And once you activate Revenge, everyone who hits you will be knocked down to the floor, your damage will be increased, you won't be able to be interrupted out of your attacks, and if you parry or throw someone, you'll be able to also knock them to the floor, guaranteeing you a very devastating punish. Now, the next mode we're going to be talking about is going to be 4v4 elimination. Same concept as 1v1s and 2v2s, you have to win 3 rounds, but this time it's a team of 4 against another team of 4, and this time you're going to have access to your feats, and you're also going to have power-ups scattered around the map. Alright, so now we're going to be talking about 4v4 skirmish. The difference between 4v4 skirmish and 4v4 elimination is that skirmish does not have rounds, it has a point system, so you get points by killing other heroes, and the first team to reach 1,000 points puts the other team in breaking, meaning that you can pick off every opponent from the enemy team one by one and they will no longer be able to respawn, and if you pick them off one by one and you kill all of them, you win the match. Okay, so now we're going to talk about For Honor's most popular mode called Dominion. Now, in Dominion, you can earn points by killing heroes, just like in Skirmish, but it's not going to be the main way that you're going to use to earn points. The main way of earning points in Dominion is by capturing the zones that are spread out on the map. There are two zones on each extremity of the map that you can capture, and there is one central zone that you can also capture on the map. Now, if you want to capture a non-central zone, you're simply going to have to stand on it while there are no enemies around, and if you have another player with you, you're going to be able to capture faster. If there are enemies on the zone, you won't be able to capture it, and you'll have to eliminate the enemies if you want to cap. Now, to capture a central zone, you're going to have to help your minions capture it, and by that I mean you're going to have to kill the other team's minions so that your own minions can push towards the enemy's territory and capture the central zone. So if you keep killing the enemy minions, eventually your minions are going to be able to catch the central zone, and you're going to be able to see if the enemy's caught it by looking at the line on the ground. If it's your team's color, that means you've captured the zone. But you didn't really capture the zone, it's your minions who have to capture the zone, and you have to help the minions. And minion kills also grant you points. And just like Skirmish, you're going to have to reach 1,000 points in order to put the enemy team in breaking and eliminate them to win the match. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about the Tribute mode of For Honor. Tribute mode is For Honor's equivalent of Capture the Flag. But the flags are actually called offerings, and the places where you have to put these offerings are called shrines. Now, your team has 3 shrines, and each of these shrines gives a specific bonus when you put an offering inside of it. For example, you would get offensive bonuses, defensive bonuses, and you would also get a bonus that allows you to see enemies through walls. The objective of Tribute Mode is to secure all 3 offerings within your shrines, and once you do that, a countdown timer will start, and you'll have to protect your shrines until the countdown timer goes to 0, and then you'll win. Okay, so now we're going to talk about For Honor's Breach Mode. So in Breach Mode, the attackers have to destroy 2 gates and kill the commander. The defenders have to defend those 2 gates and defend their commanders should the 2 gates be breached. And as an attacker, you have to help your minions push the ram by killing the enemy defending minions that are guarding it. When the ram reaches a gate, as an attacker, you have to prevent it from being damaged by minions, and you also have to prevent it from being hit by the cauldron, shown by a blue indicator on your map. The cauldron drops molten lava on your ram, damaging it, and if the enemy defenders drop enough cauldrons on your ram, they win the match, because your ram gets destroyed. In Breach, you have power-ups, ballistas, and offerings that can increase the health of your gate or your ram, and you also have a special area where you fight the Guardian. Killing the Guardian grants you and your team a buff in speed, damage, and defense, allowing you to kill opponents and minions faster. When you destroy both gates, you will be given a limited amount of respawns, and you will have to destroy the commander. If the commander dies, you win. If the commander survives and you run out of respawns and die, or your ram gets destroyed, the defenders win. Okay, so now we're going to talk about For Honor's Arcade mode, included with the Marching Fire expansion. In this mode, you complete quests with a varying degree of difficulty, and you have modifiers that affect the flow of battle in a positive or negative way. You can play this game mode alone or with a friend, and the gear that you unlock is dependent on the difficulty of the quest that you've just completed. Sometimes Ubisoft likes to give us special event game modes such as Test Your Metal and Jormungandr's Wrath. These events only last for a limited amount of time, so play them whenever they are available. Now, as you complete matches in For Honor, you will get gear that allows you to get perks. Now, You can earn gear by scavenging crates, by leveling up, and of course, by completing matches. And you will have three pieces of gear for your weapon. You will have one piece of gear for your chest, one for your arms, and one for your helmet. And if we look at one piece of gear, we can see that on the bottom right, each piece of gear that you collect is associated with a perk. It gives you perk points, and you need to have 600 perk points to activate your perk. Now, perks are like passive abilities that you have to earn by leveling up your gear. And you can have perks for attacking, defending, assisting, and moving around faster. Now, when you earn 600 perk points, your perk will start glowing, which is the confirmation that you have activated it. Now, to get more perk points out of a specific piece of gear, you will need to upgrade it using salvage and steel. To acquire salvage, you will need to destroy the gear that you do not use. Now, to acquire steel, you can get it from the store for real money. You can get it by completing training trials, and you can also get it by completing the story mode. But the best way to get steel is always going to be by doing orders. Now, orders have a specific time where they reset, and you have your daily orders, your contract orders, and your event orders, which grant you the most steel. Now, steel also allows you to purchase emotes, effects, executions, and character customization items such as outfits, and it also allows you to purchase new heroes. Okay, so now it's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed making it. If you liked the video, please consider giving this video a like and subscribing to the channel. Also, if you liked it, check out some of my other videos. I have other guides on this channel that you might be interested in. But for the time being, I will see you in the next video.